Hi friends, I'm Dharmala Shri from Smart Leaders IAS. So now we are going to see the articles which came on Feb 5. Here we are going to see about two articles. The first one is India can't be a refugee capital, and the next one is work while studying. So these two we are going to see now. So first article, if that door shuts now. So which is about, it is nothing about India can't be a refugee capital, which was cited by our additional Solicitor General in the Supreme Court. So we will see what is the ramification of this policy if we are not opening our door to the refugees. So it is not particular to the Rohingyas alone, others as well. From our exam point of view, which is highly relevant, in 2013 there was a question as Shahbagh Square, which happened in Bangladesh, and its relevance in India, and the Maldives crisis and its impact on India. So we can expect a question directly, what can be a Rohingya crisis and its impact on India, or what is this this area itself, why can't we open our doors to the refugees, and what is the impact, whether we are departing ourselves from our traditional stand, or the next area may be Rohingya crisis and its security ramifications. These are the areas can be relevantly asked, and as usual we can see, we can expect the area from South China also with respect to this part, Rohingya crisis. Let us move on to the article now. What is the crux of the article? So here, the first statement says that we do not want India to become the refugee capital of the world. So author points out that there are four observations from the statement, we do not want to become the refugee capital of the world. So the four observations are, here the first statement is we. So we means who? We the people, which is mentioned in our preamble, or the parliament, which says that we, either Lok Sabha alone can't do, or Rajya Sabha alone can't do, which is the whole parliament can do, or the government. So whom we are stating that we, because it is without consensus. And the next one is rulers dharma, is it is given in the Sanskrit, so I have taken only the English part. Here rulers dharma is good of many and the happiness of many. So good of many and the happiness of many, it is a rulers dharma, which is what we are following from the Nehruvian period, and now we are slightly deviating, or totally deviating from our value system. The next one is India's neighborhood are facing such a dire, I mean, either from the Pakistan migration, or from the Tibetan issue, or whether Sri Lankan issue, I mean Indo-Bangladesh during 1971, and because of this vulnerability present in our neighborhood, people are coming towards India. They feel that India is a sanctuary, not because of sanctuary. And the fourth aspect, as we are closing our doors, so we are forgetting our humanness present in our individual itself, and the human part itself. So why government is not allowing the Rohingya Muslims in entering into our land? So there are some valid reasons. The main reason is that security concerns. We are getting enough reports that at ISIS is giving training to the Rohingya Muslims, and they have every potential capabilities to operate in the India. So this is a serious concern, and government is worrying about that. So it is an executive decision that it is a right of every government to deport the illegal migrants. So we cannot go and say that government has followed this policy and that policy. And the next one is government, this Rohingya, through Rohingya migrants, hawala route, and this illegal money laundering is happening here. And the next one is we are not completely closing our doors with iron hand. We are helping in terms of so many other things. We are providing food. That is this Operation Insaniyat. So through Operation Insaniyat, we are able to deliver the foods to the camps in tons of amount, and the shelters as well. The next one is, already our northeast border is with so many security ramifications, and now the fragile border gets further worsened because of this flooding of Rohingyas. Because of this, we should shut our doors? So absolutely not, because we have signed UN resolution as well, 1948, Declaration of Human Rights Act, even though we are not signing any special rights for the refugees. But our traditional policy, which is uploaded by the UNHCR in 2013, and every other country should learn from India in terms of refugee handling and the humanness which we are showing. And so we need to we need not to dilute our international value, because we are rising a responsible global power. And the next one is, by closing the doors to Rohingya Muslims, because they were the minority communities, it shows the religious color as well, because we are allowing the citizenship for the minorities in our neighboring countries, especially Hindus, in 2016, the Citizenship Act. This shows a religious color, and it gives the other names to the India at the international stage. And the next one is, yes, we are absolutely okay with the security ramification. We need to strengthen our borders first, and we need to allow the people who is in the need to live. We will not shut our door like that. Let us move on to the next article. It is work with study. This article is about vocational education and unskilled development and in agriculture, which is relating and employment. So what is a UPSC interested area? We'll see now. So in 2015, Skill India was asked, Skill India and Make in India and jobless growth. And the next one is livestock rearing and employment opportunities. And apart from that, we can expect a question and essay as well. So while we are studying, please integrate your, don't be compartmentalized, whether it is a GS3, because you can expect GS3 as GS3 in terms of agriculture and employment. And with respect to education, you can expect in GS1 and GS2 as well. So please don't compartmentalize your area of knowledge and while studying. So integrate your ideas so that you can get wide varieties of ideas. It can be more useful when you are writing essays. So the expected area can be Skill India in the education, and the next one is role of education and in doubling the farmer's income. We have set our mission to doubling the farmer's income in 2022. So area of interest for UPSC will be doubled in this aspect. So we need to focus more here. So what is the crux of the article? Pratham used to conduct annual survey of education report, or the ASER report famously. So this year also they have conducted, but the main and key feature here is that they have conducted survey for 14 to 18 year age group, mainly because this focus gives you how far the higher education, I mean from the primary education to the next level of education, how many students are going in and going out, and in this area how many people are dropped out and going for the work. So this is the main interest area. So here we can find so many areas as which is shocking to us, because 14.4% of the people are not going to the schools. So this shows that availability and the affordability of school, well, after 9th standard or 10th standard, which is highly questionable still. Even after we are enabling a right to education, which came almost a decade. And the next one is 14.4% are not enrolled in the school. Well, also only 5.53% are engaged in the vocational group, those who are opting for the school. So this shows that skill is still dealing with our studies. So practical and theory, which is still a wider gap. And the next one is, in that 14.4%, 79% of the people are working in farming. So it is a major highlight which is shown in this report, because now we can see how farming can be a tool used for promoting vocational education. So we can have so many benefits in this area, and absolutely with some concerns as well. So author says that through this vocational education, we can impart technical aspects to the students with respect to agriculture. So we can improve the farming and impart technology into the farming, and we can create employment. And the next one is, he says that there is some professionalism will enter into the agriculture, and the stress level also can be reduced. So what are the benefits if we are allowing our students to get vocational studying in the agriculture? So what will be the expected benefits? The first one is, value chain can be streamlined, because as of now the linkages between farm and the plate, it is highly mismatched and not linked properly. So it can be effectively addressed if our students has been imparted the technical knowledge through vocational education in the area of agriculture. And the next one is, we are facing highly stressed agriculture in India. So everywhere farmers users are getting impressed. So this can be a solution for reducing the stress in agriculture. So we can use our expertised persons here. The next one is, skill development in agriculture can be widened and improved from the base level. The next generation of agriculture will be a scientifically and skillfully developed agriculture one. And the next one is, innovation and employment in the agriculture sector can be boosted, because we are focusing now more on food processing as well. So here we need so much of innovation, and we are facing the climate change in the phenomena and the changing crop patterns with respect to the climate change. So here we need so much of innovation, technology, and the employability in India, which is getting reduced. We are having so much of demographic divide and people. So we need to give the work to them without creating surplus in the primary sector, or we cannot expect the improvements in the industrial sector as well. So because it is a raw material part of the industry part. So if we want to get success in the Make in India, we need to get success in the doubling the farmers' income in 2022 and with not only with the production but also with the productivity. And the next one is sustainable agriculture is the theme which is getting focused in the global area. So organic farming and the sustainable agriculture it is an area of interest for now and the future. So it draws the attraction of the educated youth as well. Next is integration of practices. So elder people knows the value of traditional farming and the youth knows the modern value. So we need to integrate the pluralistic aspects of Indian agriculture into the global arena so that pan-India agriculture can be known to everyone and we can elevate our agriculture to our next level. And already this model, vocational education to the students, and is highly successful in Africa. It was started in 2003 and now they are reaping the benefits. So we can try in a pilot basis now and we can implement all over India later. So it is our right time. We need to link our human capital, which is highly potential and active now. And we need to link our agriculture, which is highly still in village sector and highly stressed. So this human capital has to go here and we need to make that connectivity via education. It is the right option that India can go to solve so many problems. Prepare well. All the best. Thank you.